so much. I want to say very simply, thank God you also mentioned that they said it's with the EFCC. So EFCC and all of the government agencies are better equipped to determine the veracity of all of the allegations. We have structures. We have the Federal Ministry of Education. We have the Nigerian Board on Technical Education. We have a governing council. All of them are saddled with the responsibility of verifying all of these allegations. Till date, some reports have gotten to me, which we are looking at. But I ask myself, as it is, till we speak, they are still allegations. And I wouldn't want you to impugn the name of an institution because one individual is facing an allegation. She has not been convicted by any court of competent jurisdiction. So I want us to be very, very careful. As the president of the Alumni Association, some those who have come to me have said, please, can we be very mature in this country? If somebody comes around and said, even my wife has been caught in adultery, because you have told me that, does not mean I should jump out and begin. This is how I will deal with her. A woman was brought before the Lord Jesus Christ, and people, witnesses also,
yes, sir,
said we caught her red-handed
with a man prostituting.
Right. What was his response?
No, he just said anyone that is free of any iniquity should be the first to stone her.
And they looked at her and said, what?
Go and sin no more.
Woman, I have not condemned you. Go and sin no more. For me, as the president of the Alumni Association, I say to you, the last rector that you refer to, as far as I'm concerned, is confronted with some allegations. She knows her own fundamental rights. She should pursue it. The government has institutions to look into the allegations until we have a final position paper from the governing council, from the Federal Ministry of Education, and a white paper by the government indicting her. It will be spurious for me, as the president of this alumni association, to condemn her. I don't. We may have differences because we have some misunderstandings here and there, but that was, as far as I'm concerned, she's confronted with allegations and what have you. I want it proven. She's not going to be the first rector of this college that has faced such. There have been one or two others, and at the end of the day, they were cleared. So how will you put your face? So let's wait for the relevant agencies to come up with their final paper. We have some interim reports on my table, which is not for your consumption. I know some what have you, but none of it has said we have indicted. So if they are still investigating, I don't have the instruments, official instruments and whatever available to EFCC or ICPC. So the best I can say is that these are still allegations. These people concerned are yet to be convicted, mark my words, by any court of competent jurisdiction. So we at the Alumni Association are still maintaining the same posture. Our college is still one noted for integrity. But go and ask, people will tell you, I am not somebody who condone any fraudulent activity. But at the same point in time, I serve a Lord that will not condemn.
Thank you.